Masjid al-Muslimin in South Carolina in North America. Tonight's lecture topic is the final lecture in his series in these 5 days which he has been in Guyana. The topic this evening is going to be racism and sectarianism. I have to my right Sheikh Sayyid Muhammad Sayyid Adli and to my left Brother Khalil. I will be the moderator this evening. My name is Ilyas. So without further ado, I wish to introduce the speaker and let him conduct this topic, the topic being racism and sectarianism.
إن الحمد لله أحمده وأستعينه وأستغفره أعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما أما بعد فإن أصدق الحديث كلام الله وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها فإن كل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار. All praise is due to Allah. I thank Him, I seek His help, His guidance and His forgiveness. I believe in Him and I trust Him. I seek refuge on Almighty Allah from the evil of our passions. Indeed, whomsoever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guides him to Al-Islam, no one can mislead him after Allah, and whomsoever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put him astray, no one can guide him after Allah. I testify openly that there is no deity worthy of worship except Allah Rabbil Alameen, and I testify that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is his messenger and the seal of all the prophets. O Muslims, you must know that the best speech is the speech of Almighty Allah, which is the Quran. The best guidance is the course of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam. The worst of all affairs is innovation and addition to the religion of Islam. Indeed, every addition to the religion of Islam will lead to hellfire. I adjure you as well as myself to fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to the best of your ability. Fear Allah and don't die unless you are Muslims. After this, I greet you all with the greeting of Al-Islam. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. May the peace and the blessing of Almighty Allah be with you all. And welcome to all of you for this special program concerning Islam and racism. In actuality, this problem which Islam came to abolish this problem out of the existence is not something that new to mankind. Racism has been known to mankind before the coming of Islam. And Islam had worked on this problem to such a degree that became the believers and the Muslims to be one nation and one ummah and one community, one family. When one member suffers, the whole body will suffer for it. The teaching of Islam, you find it polish this problem and work very hard about remove it from the existence of mankind. You find Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala spoke about the differences in the creation of mankind, the different of colors, the different of language and tongues, not to be used for superiority among the human being. As Almighty said, وَمِنْ آيَاتِهِ اخْتِلَافُ أَلْسِنَتِكُمْ وَأَلْوَانِكُمْ. Indeed, among the signs of Almighty Allah is the differences in your language and your color. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Almighty, our Creator, draw our attention to reflect and to see His signs, not only in the horizon, but to see the signs of Almighty Allah everywhere and even in ourselves and among ourselves. The signs of Almighty Allah, what is the purpose of the signs of Almighty Allah? Is to show you the ability of Almighty, your Creator, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to show you that the mighty of Almighty Allah, and this to fill your heart with more faith and to be more strong in your deen and in your iman. The differences in the colors, the difference in the language, this is not to be taken for any other reason. Is not to be the difference in the colors, the difference in the person's skin color is not the differences in our colors is a sign of Almighty Allah. How he made one human being white, how he make another human being black, how he make another person brown and yellowish. All this is not mean anything. Skin color doesn't mean give you superiority over another person. The same thing, the language. Somebody speaks French, somebody speaks Spanish, somebody speaking in Arabic. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants us as a human being to reflect on all this, and he says that this among his signs. The same way that he created the moon, he created the sun, he created the stars, and all these things, by reflecting on it, it increases your faith, increases your iman, it leads you to your Creator, Almighty Allah, to know about His ability, His power. So the same thing, by reflecting on our language, the differences in our languages, by reflecting in our skin color, all these things supposed to lead us to know that Almighty Allah is the Creator. It's much easier than the Creator make everybody look the same. It's much easier that Almighty the Creator make everybody speak the same language. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala shows you His ability by creating male and female, by creating black and white, yellowish and brownish, by making somebody speak Arabic, somebody speak English, somebody speak Arabic. So now the problem when a human being tries to create a differences or make superiority between among themselves as based on the language or based on the sex or based on the color. And if we reflect on this, we found that we don't have anything to do with our color. We did not give the color to ourselves. It's God's creation. And your color doesn't make you smarter than the other person. So you're born with this color. You have no choice about it. So how come now we can create differences among ourselves or make my skin color to give me privilege over you? This is not what Almighty Allah had intended for the differences in our language, our height, our shapes, our color, our language. What is the base of superiority in Islam? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala stated in his book, Ya ayyuhan nas, inna khalaqnakum min dhakarin wa unsa, wa ja'alnakum shu'uban wa qabaila lita'arafu, inna akramakum عند الله أتقاكم. This Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, our creator, addressing all mankind. O mankind, indeed we created you from a single male and female. إِنَّا خَلَقْنَاكُمْ يَا أَيُّهَا النَّاسِ إِنَّا خَلَقْنَاكُمْ مِنْ ذَكَرٍ وَأُنْثَى. You've been created, produced out of a male and female from the first man, which is Adam and Eve. If we can use the term Eve or Hawa, we produce you, we created you, min dhakarin wa unsa, and we made you into tribe and nations. We made you into tribes and nations. Lita'arafu. So the purpose that Almighty Allah made us into tribes and nations, not that we fight against each other, or that we misuse this differences, but to get to know each other. Because if everybody looked white, or everybody looked the same height, or everybody talk in the same language, or everybody have the same shape, we could not. But Allah Almighty, our Creator, to make it more easier on us, that He made us into tribes and nations, families, and countries and nations and all these things. So you can relate to each other. You get to, will be much easier in you to recognize each other. And after this, what Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, إِنَّ أَكْرَمَكُمْ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ أَتْقَاكُمْ. Indeed, the best among you is the taller, the shorter, the more money, the darker color. None of this. Who is the best among us? إِنَّ أَكْرَمَكُمْ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ أَتْقَاكُمْ. The best among you and the most honorable among you in the sight of Almighty Allah is the one who more God fearing, the one who has more taqwa, the person who submit himself willingly to the will of Allah and the struggle more in worshiping and serving Almighty Allah, which is part of the worship, is to assist and help the other fellow human being. So those who have more taqwa, those who worship in Almighty Allah more, those who serve mankind and assist mankind more, those who are the best. Those who are the best. So now we understand why Almighty Allah made these differences among ourselves. And why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala Almighty had made the difference in our skin color, in our, how Almighty Allah made us into tribes and nations. So now we need to understand the purpose that Almighty Allah made us into this. And we appreciate and thank Almighty Allah that He made us into this. And to reflect on it, and this reflection on this, it should make us more stronger in our faith. Not to create a differences among ourselves, and to start to become a basis of differences and arguments and debates and fussing in each other, and to try to abuse one another or try to segregate one another or try to block our way to communicate and united with each other. The same thing the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam in his teaching, in his saying, in the authentic sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, emphasized the same teaching of the Quran, explain the Quran more in details to let us know that these differences in color and in shapes is nothing except one of Allah's signs, and for us to do the best out of it by saying إن الله لا ينظر إلى صوركم وأموالكم ولكن ينظر إلى قلوبكم التي في الصدور أو كما قال صلى الله عليه وسلم وإلى أعمالكم. The meaning of the statement of the Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, that Almighty Allah, He doesn't care for your looks. He doesn't care too much about your property, how much money you got, or what color of skin you got, or what shape you got. What Almighty Allah looks, when He looks to the human being, He looks to your heart. Your heart, which in your chest, what's in your heart, the love, the ability of to love each other, to care for one another, to assist one another. What is taqwa? What is the piety? What is the faith that in your heart? But how tall you are is not going to make difference. How dark you are is not going to make a difference. So Allah Almighty, He doesn't care for your looks, neither He care for your color or for your property. What Allah looks to your heart and to your deed. You want to be a better person than me? Do more good deeds than me. Now you have superiority over me. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala established a brotherhood and sisterhood. What He said? إِنَّمَا الْمُؤْمِنُونَ إِخْوَةٌ. Indeed, the believers are brothers. Although we understand that the Quran, when it started to be revealed, and Islam, when revealed to the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, came in Arabia. But how much we see the Quran talks about the Arab. So the existence of Arab in the Quran, it almost to be a zero, because Islam started in Arabia, but He didn't give any superiority for the Arab over the non-Arab. And the establishment of brotherhood and unity was not because they are Arab. And among the believers and among the early Muslims,
يفاول بلال may Allah be pleased with him. And Bilal was from Abyssinia. You found Salman from Persia, Salman al Farisi. You found Abu Bakr al Siddiq, he's Arab. So in the first, the early Muslim community, you found different colors, different countries, different language. And after this, Islam came to say to them what? إِنَّمَا الْمُؤْمِنُونَ إِخْوَةَ. It didn't say, indeed the Arab are brothers, or indeed the black are brothers, or indeed the Spanish are brothers, but said, إِنَّمَا الْمُؤْمِنُونَ إِخْوَةَ. Indeed the believers are brothers. So doesn't matter what color, or what country you came from, or what language, as long you testify to the unity and the oneness of Almighty Allah, and the finality of the Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, you are a member of this family. Now your color, your history, your culture, all the things have to sit behind a curtain and burial away from Al-Islam. No, now your background has no existence in Al-Islam. Everything is going to be divorced. Everything is going to be divorced. You have to start a new page when you say, أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وأشهد أن محمد رسول الله. I testify that there is no deity worthy of worship except Almighty Allah. I testify that Muhammad is the messenger of Allah. Now by announcing this statement, now you are a newborn Muslim in a new system, in a new everything, in new teaching, in a new code of life. So everything before has no place in Al-Islam. How you used to do this and how you used to understand this, everything comes when Islam comes to your life. That means a divorce for everything before. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala establish unity, establish brotherhood only among the believers. He didn't use language, he didn't use color, he didn't use any background to bring this unity. And the moment that we start to play on this background of what you came from and what I came from, this is a division. This is a disunity. And this is again is the teaching of Al-Islam and the Sunnah of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. To such a degree, even Islam is saying, لا يسخر قوم من قوم عسى أن يكونوا خيرا منهم ولا نساء من نساء عسى أن يكون خيرا منهم. Let not a group of people mock other group of people. You may don't like the way how he dressed. You may don't like the way what is his skin color. You may don't like, you understand, his height. You don't like whatever it is. But you don't know what his heart is. You don't know the faith, the belief in Allah. So Allah is warning the believers, warning the Muslims, don't look down upon somebody else under the shade of La ilaha illallah Muhammadur Rasulullah. Because maybe this person that you're looking down on him because his color, or because he don't have much money like you, or he don't speak the same language as you, he may be in the sight of Allah much better than you. لا يسخر قوم من قوم عسى أن يكونوا خيرا منهم. And this also not to be done by women, because Islam didn't come for men, neither Islam come for women. Islam came for everybody. As the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said about one of his speciality, that each prophet before used to come only for his community, but I've been commissioned to everyone, black, white, Arab, non-Arab, male and female. You found the uniqueness of Al-Islam when he talks, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala addressed mankind. He didn't say, oh Arab, oh black, oh Indian, oh Spanish. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala spread the message to every human being. Said, Ya ayyuhal nas. Ya ayyuhal nas, oh mankind. This da'wah of Al-Islam is a da'wah for every human being, regardless if he speaks Arabic or no. Islam, again, didn't come for the Arab. And as I stated, the early Muslim community exists from the Arab, from the Abyssinian, from the Persian, from every name you can imagine that a country, a person coming from, or a language, or different colors, and all of them come under La ilaha illallah, Muhammadur Rasulullah. The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam established the same thing, that لا فضل لعربي على عجمي ولا لأبيض على أسود إلا بالتقوى أو كما قال صلى الله عليه وسلم. There is no superiority for a Arab over non-Arab. Neither there is a superiority for a black over white or a white over black. Except the only thing will make a difference between me and you is the taqwa of Allah, the fear of Allah, your faith, your deen, how you practice your deen, this will make different who is better. But my skin color, I didn't give the color to myself. Neither has anything I can do about my skin color. If I'm brown, I could not change it. If I'm white, I could not change it. I have no choice. I came like this from my mother womb. God made me this way. So how I can go challenge you or feel them are better than you because something that I had it, I have no control over it. Somebody with a green eyes or brown eyes, he didn't give the color to itself. So your skin color doesn't mean anything. You are a human being not by your skin color. You are a human being by what you believe in, by what you're willing to do for mankind, why you living for, what you live for. This was going to make a difference. But if we sit here fussing about my color and your color, your history and my history, what I'm going to do with my history? My history is Islam. And without Islam, who I am? Islam is what gave me the honor. And what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, وَلِلَّهِ الْعِزَّةِ وَلِرَسُولِهِ وَلِلْمُؤْمِنِينَ. Indeed, the honor is for Allah, His Messenger, and those who align themselves with the line of Allah and His Messenger, which is the believers. وَلَكِنَّ أَكْثَرَ النَّاسِ لَهُ. But most mankind, they don't understand this. You see? So the honor, what is make you superior, is when you align yourself with the order of Allah and the authentic sunnah of the Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. This is what Allah is saying. العزه, the honor, the mighty. For who? For Allah, His Messenger, and for the believers. So faith, which make you believers, has no color, has no country. What is the root of Islam? Allah and His Messenger. The root of Islam comes from Allah. It didn't come from Africa. It didn't come from India. It didn't come from Spain. It didn't come from Arabia. Who legislated Islam? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Who taught us Islam? If from Allah to Jibreel to the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So Islam has nothing to do with Africa. Islam has nothing to do with India. Islam has nothing to do with Arabia. Yes, Islam started in Arabia, but what culture in Islam that teach about you have to be Arab? There's nothing in Islam tell you that you have to be Arab. But is what's in Islam? To be a believer. To be a believer. And when you come to be a believer, now you are a member of this family that call Muslims. But if we hang over this mentality of background and history and the color, how far is this going to take us? It's going to create a new fitna, a new confusion, a new misunderstanding, and we sit debating and argue about what happened before, what happened after, what these things. We're never going to build a future because we keep sitting debating about what had happened before. So Islam is our past, Islam is our present, Islam is our future. Otherwise, you taking the steps of the shaitan, Satan. When Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He command Iblis to prostrate to Adam. What did Iblis say? He said, أنا خير من. Allah Almighty, Adam in Jannah, and Iblis was in Jannah. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He commands the angel to prostrate to Adam. To prostrate to him, not a form of worship, a form of honor and respect. And to acknowledge this creation that Allah had created with His own hand. What did Iblis say? Iblis didn't say, oh, I didn't understand this language. He didn't say, I didn't understand that I'm supposed to prostrate. But what did Iblis say? He said, I am better than him. That means, yes, Allah, I heard you, and I understand what you're saying to prostrate to Adam, but I'm not going to prostrate. He disobeyed. What? He said, Ana khayrun min. I am better than Adam. How? He said, because you created me from fire and you created him from dirt. You see? So this analysis, okay, of Iblis, he never say, I didn't understand, but his problem that he feels that he's better. He is better. Better for what? Because the substance, I, Iblis, been created from fire. Adam, human being, been created from dirt, from dust. But how do you know that fire is better than dust? Who told you this? Let's even assume that fire is better than dirt. But the Creator, your Master, Allah Almighty, is saying to you to prostrate. So this is a problem. So what happened now? So Allah said to Iblis to get out because you could not be in paradise with this, to be proud, to be arrogant. So the same way when you think that your skin make you better than the other person, or your history because you came from India, or you came from Africa, or you're coming from the moon, or from wherever you're coming. What does this mean? Now, I'm better than him. For what? Because your skin? Because you're taller than him? Because you have some money? What make you better? You don't know what's make you better. You see? So now, you taking, you're aligning yourself with Iblis. You now try to revive the same motion that been raised before by Iblis, the father of all the devils, when he said to Allah Almighty, I'm better than him. Why? Because my creation, my substance, my original is better than him. No, we could not be like Iblis. Neither are we going to imitate Iblis. Allah told us, وَمِنْ آيَاتِهِ اخْتِلَافُ أَلْسِنَتِكُمْ وَأَلْوَانِكُمْ. It is among his signs, the differences of your tongue and your color. So this is the limit. This all what I'm going to understand about it, that this is one of the miracles of Almighty Allah. This is one of the signs of Almighty Allah that I have a skin different from your skin. This is it. And now I believe that Almighty Allah can make our skins different, can make our height different. This is it. I could not go beyond this. I could not make my skin give me a level of be proud, feel arrogant, or feel whatever it is, I'm better than him for whatever reason. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam had informed us about the seriousness of this matter by saying, لا يدخل الجنة من كان في قلبه مثقال ذرة من كبر. No one among you will enter paradise, heaven, whatever name you want to call it. I assume that you know what is Jannah. Okay? This is the place which we've been promised by Allah for reward and blessings. He said, no one will enter paradise if he has the little bit of pride in his heart. This is the sickness. This is illness of the heart. A person, when he's arrogant, he feels that he's too good, that I'm better than somebody else. If you have this illness, even so small, as much as an atom, you could not enter paradise. So one of the Sahaba said, O Prophet of Allah, one of us, he liked to have a nice shoes, a nice soap. Is this